Many of you have asked me how I add the subscribe animation to my videos. This part here, the little hand subscribed, hitting the bell, and then it swoops away off the screen. I'm going to show you how I source that animation, where I got it from, where I store it on my computer, how I access it every week to create my YouTube videos, and how you can do the same. We're going over to Google. And I put in here YouTube subscribe animation. And if you go down to the first result, which is Pixabay, and click on that, you will see that they have 40 different effects, different animations that you can access. So this is on Pixabay. You can see that there are a variety of them. The one that I used and the one I downloaded was this one right here called it says 4K, it's a 10 second animation. So what I'm going to do is click on that. And then what I'll do is click on free download and then download this to my computer. Now that file, that video file exists on my computer. What I did was I created a folder. I call it YouTube Video Elements. These are elements that I use every single week in my projects. And in here are end cards, different bugs for Instagram and TikTok and things like that. And right here in green, you can see the MP4 video file that I just downloaded from Pixabay. I use this element every single week, so I like to have it in its own folder for easy access. Now what I do is I am opening up a project. So let's go over here to a project, and at the very beginning of this project, there, you can even see it on the timeline. See this little green? That's the animation. I can tell by looking at it, and I can also see it up here in my media bin. So all I do to bring this into my bin is I press on the plus sign, I go import media. In my case, I know that I keep my folder on my desktop, and it's called YouTube Elements, and it's right here. I go in, I grab this, and I import it into the project. So I'm going to show you an example of how this works. If I were to drag and drop my element onto the timeline. Now, obviously, you don't want this to take up the entire screen. So grab it from any corner and resize it to the size you want. With your cursor, you can then move it around to the location on the screen where you want this animation to appear. Let's say we like it here in the bottom right-hand corner. In visual effects, you're going to go down to remove a color. Drag and drop remove a color onto the element. Click on the little arrow to verify that it's there, and you can see that it's there. Remove color has been added to this element. Now when we hit highlight this element, click on properties, and when you scroll down, you will see the remove a color visual effect is now listed on the menu here on the right hand side. When you see this, you're going to click on the little green box, click on the little pencil select color from image icon, and then click on the green part of the element. It's not 100% yet though, because now it still looks gray. It doesn't have a 100% transparency to it. So what you'll do then is go over to the tolerance and just ever so gently drag this button over just a tad. It's just ever so slight, and that will calibrate this. You can see it still a little bit on the purple. Let me see if I can make that a little bit better on the tolerance. Just go over one more. There we go. There we go. Perfect. And now if I play this out, so watch what happens. There it is. And I don't have the volume here. I'll show you with the volume. Let me go back. I just don't want it to interfere with my voice right now, but watch this. If you find that that bell sound is too loud, you can just go into the volume section, the audio properties, and just bring this down just a tad. And I do like to do that. I find that it's a little bit too loud as it is. Just go back in here. and listen to that once more. There, it's not quite as in your face. And like I said, you would move this element to wherever you want it to appear on the timeline. I like it to appear closer to the front end of the video before I get into the meat and potatoes of the actual edit. I hope this is helpful for you. Have fun with this. Increase your subscribers on your videos by eliciting an action from them and adding this animation. Have fun.